In a land far, far away, a king with the name of DNA the First ruled over a kingdom of unimaginable dimension. Never in history was there a mind so brilliant like the one of DNA the First. It was like a dictionary having answers to all the questions. In order to stay safe, the king never left his castle. Also, the walls of his castle were so high and so strong, hardly anybody was able to enter the castle at will. In order to share ideas and information to rule the kingdom and let it thrive and prosper, the king communicated with the outside world by sending simple letters. If he feared, for instance, the lack of security at the border of his lands, he took a quill and wrote down his ideas in an encrypted message on a piece of parchment and sent it outside of his castle. The letter arrived in a facility able to decrypt the information in the letter to train the soldiers equipped with the necessary weapons. They were sent to the borders of the kingdom, ready to provide security. In order to prevent the genius ideas written in the letter to get into the wrong hands, the letter was burned as soon as the facility completed its production. DNA the First was envied due to the brilliance of his ruling, which is why many enemies appeared, trying to destroy the kingdom. But the king wouldn't be king if he had no answers to those foreign forces. Having many soldiers equipped with a plethora of skills and weapons was a basic shield against attacks, but the kingdom developed more and more strategies by learning from its enemies. For a very long time, the king forced ways of attracting foreign soldiers into traps, taking them hostage to learn about them and to find ways to fight them effectively. New soldiers with better weapons were trained to immunize and protect the kingdom for generations to come in case the enemy dared to start a fight. In the course of time, DNA the First gathered quite some allies who respected the king for what he had created. The king himself trusted his new allies in the hope for his kingdom to thrive and prosper even more. These allies contributed to other ways to secure the kingdom. Whenever they sensed a potential threat, they sent a letter to the kingdom's facilities. Like the king's messages, the allies' letter was also encrypted, and new soldiers with better weapons they didn't know before were trained. As usual, the letters were burned to prevent the information to get into the wrong hands or to distract the king in his castle of his other obligations. The new soldiers were sent to the borders of the kingdom, ready to fight against the potential threat whenever its forces should dare to appear. By using old and new strategies and taking support of his allies, DNA the First was able to make his kingdom a safe place in which its residents were supporting each other to live a pleasant life. This is called DNA. DNA contains two strands which are interwoven with each other. And that's why it's called a double-stranded molecule. It is made from molecules which create a code for all genes important for your body. Each gene contains the information to produce proteins, which for instance make the color of your eyes or help you digest food or make you walk. The DNA can be found in every cell of your body and sits safely in a specific compartment within the cell called the nucleus. And it is not able to leave this compartment like the king who sits safely in its castle in the fairy tale. A fun fact is that your body contains 21,000 protein coding genes, which means that these 21,000 genes make the proteins to keep you alive. The production of proteins derived from DNA is a highly regulated process. In a first step called transcription, the information of a gene on the DNA is written down in a molecule called messenger RNA, or also known as the mRNA. As I stated before, that DNA is a double-stranded molecule, which means that it has two strands which are interwoven with each other, as you can see here. But the mRNA is a single-stranded molecule, and also a very unstable one. The mRNA, or the messenger RNA, which is formed from the DNA, is transported out of the nucleus to another compartment in the cell. Now, the mRNA is copied into a protein by a process called translation. Completed proteins are then transported to wherever they are needed. As the mRNA is not needed anymore, it is an unstable molecule anyway, as stated earlier, and it is degraded as soon as this process is completed. Now, let's link this story to the fairy tale story. DNA being the king, mRNA being the letter which is given from the king to the soldier, and the soldiers are the proteins. As the letter is burned after the proteins get the message, thereby or similarly, the mRNA is also degraded after it has been processed or copied into a protein. So what happens in a classical vaccination is that a solution of foreign soldiers is injected into your body, and they enter the cells and train your body soldiers in order to fight a virus. Now let's link it to the scientific terms. So the foreign soldiers are the proteins which are injected into your body, and then these enter the cells, and these proteins train your immune cells, which fight against the virus. So what happens in an mRNA vaccination is that a group or a solution of letters are injected into your body, and the letters enter the cells where they have the information to make the foreign soldiers. Now these foreign soldiers then train the body soldiers to prepare a fight against the virus. Now let's link it to the scientific terms. The letters are the mRNAs which are injected into your body. They enter the cells, and these mRNA have the information to make the foreign soldiers, which are the foreign proteins in your body. And these foreign proteins then train the immune cells in order to fight against the virus.